Hello everyone, welcome to the online lecture series in the course Information Theory and Coding. The contents of this lecture are from Unit 3, that is Channel Coding. As we have already discussed block codes in detail previously, now let us discuss what are linear block codes in this particular lecture. And thereafter, we shall also discuss the various types of linear block codes. So the contents of the lecture first, we shall have a look at what are linear codes, followed by different types of linear block codes such as single parity check bit code, repeated code, Hadamard code, Hamming code, and Reed-Muller code. So what are linear codes? The definition of linear block code is given as follows. A block code is said to be a linear code if its code words satisfy the condition that the sum of any two code words gives another code word. This also can be called as the linearity property. So let us consider a code C, and CI and CJ are two code words belonging to code C. If at all I take the modulo 2 addition of CI and CJ, then I get CK. And if this CK is also a code word belonging to this code C, then the code is called as a linear code. So basically, we take any two code words, and if at all we take the sum, that is modulo 2 addition, or in other words XOR operation, if it is performed, then the resultant what we get is also a code word, then it is called as a linear code. So let us take an example of a 6,3 block code. So when I say 6,3, n is equal to 6 and k is equal to 3. So k is equal to 3 means there are 3 message bits, and hence we have 8 possible combinations of the message bits or 8 data words, and hence we have 8 code words. Now each of these code words are of 6 bits because n is equal to 6. So we have also calculated the weight of this code word, as we know that weight is nothing but the number of ones in a particular code word. So here the weight is 3, here the weight is 4, and so on and so forth. So in order to check whether this code is linear or not, let us take two code words C2 and C3. Next, what I do is that I find the modulo 2 addition of these two code words. That is nothing but XOR operation has to be performed. So we take the first bit and the first bit of the second code word, 0 XOR 0, answer is 0. Second bit, 0 XOR 1, answer is 1. Third bit, 1 XOR 0, answer is 1. Fourth bit, 1 XOR 1, answer is 0. Fifth bit, 1 XOR 0, answer is 1. And last bit, again the answer is 1. So what we get is, we get 011011. If at all we check it in the set of code words, we see that this is nothing but code word C4. So basically, we have taken two code words, and the modulo 2 addition of those two code words, also we have found that it is also a code word. So this is a linear code. The same thing can be checked for all the other code words. So what are the properties of linear code? There are three properties. First property, the all zero word is always a code word. So let us have a look at our example. In this, we have all zero code word present. All the 6 bits are zero. So the first property of a linearity code is satisfied by this particular code word, this particular code. Second property, given any 3 code words CI, CJ and CK such that CK is equal to CI plus CJ, then the distance between two code words equals the weight of sum of the code words. That is, distance between CI and CJ is nothing but same as the weight of the resultant code word CK. So again, we shall take the same example. We have two code words C2 and C3. Now what is the Hamming distance between two code words? We have to check bit by bit how many bits are different. So if at all we see first bit in two code words is same, second bit is different, third bit is different, fourth bit is same, fifth bit is different, sixth bit is different. So we have four bits in which both the code words differ, and hence Hamming distance between C2 and C3 is 4. Next, we find out what is the weight of the resultant code word, that is C4, that is number of ones which are present here. There are 4 ones, so the weight of the code word C4 is 4. So hence we can see that this property also can be verified for this particular code. Third property is that the minimum distance of the code D minimum is equal to W minimum, where W minimum is the weight of any non-zero code word with the smallest weight. So what we can see here is that the smallest non-zero code word weight is 3, and the minimum distance of this code will be nothing but 3. Next, we go to single parity check bit codes. As the name suggests, there will be a single parity bit which will be added to the message bits in this particular code. So this code is a single error detecting block code, and it will not correct any errors. So as I have told you, it uses a single parity check bit. The parity bit can be even parity bit or odd parity bit. So as we have already studied what is the meaning of even parity, for even parity, P is equal to 0 if the number of ones in the data word are even. Otherwise, P will be equal to 1. What is odd parity? Odd parity, the parity bit P is equal to 0 if the number of ones in the data word are odd. Otherwise, P is equal to 1. So basically, for a single even parity check bit, the equation is given by parity bit is nothing but M1 XOR M2 XOR M3 up till MK. So basically, even parity bit is nothing but the XOR of all the message bits. But if at all I ask you what is the equation for odd parity check bit, then we have to take the XNOR operation and not XOR operation. So basically, for any n, k single parity check code, there are k message bits where k is variable, but r is fixed, that is your redundant bit or parity bit is always equal to 1, and hence the total number of bits can be written as k plus 1. The rate of the code, which is nothing but k upon n, can be written as k upon k plus 1. We shall take an example of 4,3 even parity check code. So as it is 4,3, n is equal to 4 and k is equal to 3. And as we know, r is equal to 1, the rate of the code is nothing but 3 by 4. So how many message bits are there? There are 3 message bits and 1 parity bit. So as there are 3 message bits, we will have 8 different combinations starting from 000 to 111. And the equation of the parity bit is given as M1 XOR M2 XOR M3. So with the help of this equation, we have found what is the parity bit. So first case, 0 XOR 0 XOR 0, parity bit is 0. 0 XOR 0 XOR 1, parity bit is 1. Since there is odd number of 1, parity bit is equal to 1. And so on and so forth. So what are the code words? we get code words bits as C1, C2, C3, C4, which is nothing but M1, M2, M3, and the fourth bit is the parity bit. So these are the code words which are generated. We have also found out what is the weight of each of these code words, and the weight is 0, 2, 2, up, and the largest weight is 4. So the smallest non-zero weight is 2, and hence, since single parity check code is a linear code, I can write that d minimum is also equal to 2, because d minimum is equal to w minimum, which is 2. And L is nothing but error detecting capability, is nothing but d minimum minus 1, 2 minus 1, which is equal to 1. And error correcting capability, d minimum minus 2 divided by 2, answer is 0. So as I have already indicated here, this code can correct single error and it will not correct any errors. Now let us have a look at how to generate the generator matrix and the parity check matrix for single parity check bit codes. So as we know, the definition of generator matrix, it is made up of two sub matrices: identity matrix of the order k cross k, that is the square matrix, and parity sub coefficient matrix, which is having the order k cross r, but in this case r is equal to 1, and hence we will get a single column matrix. So for 4,3 even parity linear block code, we get the generator matrix like this, that is k is equal to 3. So we get an identity matrix of the order 3 cross 3, and then I get a single column matrix which has got 3 rows. Similarly, if at all we want to find the parity check matrix, according to the equation, parity check matrix is made up of P transpose and IR, and P transpose now will have R cross K as the order, so it will have 1 row and K columns. So basically it is a single row matrix, and IR is nothing but a single element, because it is I1, and I1 is nothing but a single one, identity matrix of the order 1, which is a single one. So the parity check matrix for 4,3 even parity linear block code is given like this, which is made up of, it is a basically a single row matrix, and it will have n number of columns, that is 4 columns. The same thing we can find for 4,5,4 even parity check code, and the generator matrix will appear like this: IK, where K is equal to 4, so identity matrix of the order 4, and single column matrix having 4 rows. Parity check matrix will be made up of single row matrix having 4 columns and another one, that is I1. Thank you everyone. In the next lecture, we will be discussing the repeated codes and Hadamard codes.